Yeah.
You have to mark cut out here for the Voluto motor wire to jump. So what we're going to do, we'll use this punch. See the mark I've made already. What we're going to do, line this up. So the pin then just off the edge. And as you can see now, we've made our mark. Next out is the drill. This one we're going to drill in a small bit to get ourselves a guideline. Change it for a larger bit. Next step, shoot. Next step now is to shoot the punch into the header box. Taking the clamp there, bring it up and in. Nut, which sits inside there, and then we're tightening from underneath then, as you can see, to get a nice bit of tension on there. Then we're going to take the Allen key. Now, as I'm tightening now, you'll see the clamp come down. You'll see it out. Next step, move this to the straight. And with the Allen key, keep turning, and it will eventually bite into the material. As you can see from the side, it's biting into the material. Keep doing that until it goes. You'll know when it goes, because this will get much easier to turn. As you can see, now I can do it with one finger. That's when you know that it punched through the fab. Next step then. Take this off. Onto there so we don't lose it. And the next step then is to get the punch out. A little bit of rope, just like top of the armour. I lost my arm. Right, once I finished cutting now, just taking the excess off. So it's all through the back of the wires. So they sit inside. Get all our wires slotting here, making the other box a better finish. And it's all tied up, nice and tidy. Two brackets. This is to hold fabric in the cassette. These go in like that. Always this bit facing in. This slots on. One side. Procedure on the opposite side. Next step. As I explained earlier about the wires, we're going to slot the wire underneath. What you must remember to do also with this, as you notice here, I've taken two plastic pieces off. The reason for that is so that this will now sit nice and flush on the bracket. As you can see down there now, it's nice and flush. So this side then, put the bracket on. Now we're going to do the opposite side. Same again, this bit into the two slots. Next step now is two sides. Again now. And you notice the difference. Two sides. This side there. You notice now when I put a screw in, 0.1, 0.2, and 0.3.
Can you show it again? Good point.
0.1, 0.2, 0.3 will match to these. And when we're putting these on, we're not going to screw them tight at the moment, and I'll explain that in just a second. We'll leave that loose at the moment, and I'll explain that now. Like, on this side, you got to make sure these wires are tucked, because otherwise they're going to get caught across here. And when you put the plate on, it's not going to sit. Whereas now, as you can see, the plate will sit nice and flush. So it's the same again, 0.1, 0.2 and 0.3. Like I said, we're not going to screw it flush at the moment. And as you can see now, the wires are not getting caught, and there's enough free play for the wires to move around. Right, the reason why I didn't tighten the box completely is now we're going to put the head on. If this was tight, then we'd have some of the certain one, which is now the slots on, and in here, you see, I'll just shut this one cut, we've got a bracket. Now inside that bracket is a screw. So we've got to try and get this as flush as we can to put a screw through here to keep the box on. You make a little mark there, so that there should line with that when we put a screw in then. And the same on the other side. And this is the reason why we're not tightening it. Next step now is to drill. I'm going to drill now on the marks that we made earlier. Same on the other side. If you put these screws in now, you're going to put through. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to pump the sink. Another handle. Touch it up with a white pen. To this side. Into the groove. And like I said before, the reason why pinkies with this. Now we can screw and tape them. And as I said before, now, no wires are getting caught, and it's all flush. I took out two, and if it's lined up, and that completes our header box. And that's the completed head box.